Hey everybody, this is Pat Foster with Swap Moto Live. We're out here at Glen Helen today for a mod squad brought to you by our friends at Liat. So I've got my buddy Todd Ford with us from Custom Upfits. And Todd, we're developing a really cool relationship where you get badass bikes and then you let me ride them first.
Exactly. Which is
the best kind of friend to have.
I'm your homie.
So we're kind of bookending the deal. A year ago, I rode your Kawasaki 450 that was built for Ken Roczen. Amazing bike. So, you know, you got one of the baddest 450s ever built on one end of the spectrum, all the way down to a 125. It's been a long time since I've ridden a 125. What was the motivation behind building this bike?
Honestly, it was coming out to the Mini Monster event, the Swap Moto Live race series.
Yep.
They did the Mini Monster, and I showed up here, and they have a 125 open class that anybody can ride. Yep. And right then and there, I was like, I asked the wife, hey, can we go to Chaparral and buy a 125? She shut it down. But, you know, we went back, and about a week later, and I called Mitch and said, hey, I want to do a 125. I know you do some for RV.
Yep.
And could you help me out? And he said, no problem. I got this RV spec, which is from Pro Circuit.
Yeah.
And so got the bike, went down there, never rode it, just brought it down and let Mitch, Snikey, and Dino just do their thing.
That's awesome. That's awesome. So you've got some trick stuff on it. I've seen kit, Showa suspension. How'd you come up with that?
So Mitch had two sets of Showa A kit for a Yamaha. One is saved for RV, and one that he had bought from, I believe, Mike or Tony Alessi. And he offered it up to me, and of course, I'm not going to say no. We're gonna buy it, and we'll put it on our 125, and it'll be super cool. Before we went down to PC, we stopped at Works Connection.
Yep.
So Eric up there at Works Connection, they're right by our shop. Went in there and they just took care of us. Every piece of bling, you know, mid-90s when you're riding a 125 or 250, you had to go to Works Connection and get the frame guard, skid plate, all that kind of stuff.
Guilty. And I had all of it.
See,
I had all of it.
So, and then with this bike too, because it doesn't have a hydraulic clutch, the Works Connection perch and lever, there's a leverage off of it. It just works amazing. So I just needed all that Works Connection bling.
And you know, a lot of bikes these days don't really need it, but 125, that quick adjust, it's going to come in handy.
It definitely will, especially with this, trying to get up that. So.
Yep, I'm with you. Well, cool. It's got all the trick stuff. Any special instruction you gave to the guys at Pro Circuit, going through the engine, pipes, anything special you were looking for?
Make it awesome.
Just make
it rip. When you have that Roczen 450, and now, you know, you want a 125 that, you know, you know that they've built some really cool ones for Villopoto and other great riders. It's just like, man, I want a 125 that sounds like I'm sitting in the stadium back in, you know, late 90s, 2000s, yep. And you're just hearing, you know, Kevin Windham or somebody on a cool 125. I want that sound. And the guy, you know, obviously Mitch is the king.
Yep.
So, you know, to have a relationship with them, because we've done some work with them on vans and stuff. So it's been a blessing on the other side of it to be able to get the thing. I mean, we still paid for it. You know, it's not like we showed up and got it for free. But, you know, they did a great job. Obviously, too, the first thing you see with the bike, though, is those Throttle Syndicate graphics. The graphics from Throttle Syndicate, Ryan and the team over there, I think they did an amazing job with this chrome backing on it. It just gives that bike that shimmer.
Yeah.
So it looks good from that side of it. And, you know, then you get down to the nuts and bolts of it, you know, with from Pro Circuit. So we've got the suspension, we've got the ignition with the mapping, the two different pieces. You know, I know you experienced that, and I did too. We did the different gearing, the head, the cylinder. And like when I was down there, Mitch had to check with the guys and say, hey, do we have a needle? We need to get some needles from Europe, because it's part of that RV spec. So if you called Pro Circuit right now, like anybody can call Pro Circuit and say, hey, I want the RV spec on my 125.
So anybody can buy this?
Yeah.
That's impressive.
And that's the cool part too, is like you can go in there and even, you know, that bike right there, you can say, hey, I want the RV spec, and drop off a brand new bike or a used bike and say, I want the RV spec, and they'll get it done for you. And
that's awesome.
And I think that's the cool part about that company, especially with the transition of companies in the industry right now. You still have the original owner, the original guy there that knows how to speak this language of a two-stroke.
So it's funny, we'll get into the bike in just a second, but I rode RV's 250 two-stroke that he raced here a few weeks ago and was talking to him about it, and he said, not only backing up what you say, right? Mitch has been there the whole time. He's like, yeah, he did some things to it that he learned on Chad Reed's bike when he was working for Chad on a two-stroke. It's like, wow, man, that's some institutional knowledge. That's cool.
It's that cycle. Yep. And having that cycle and being around people that know it, and that little team that Mitch has down there is so rad. But and I think it's cool that anybody can go there. And yep. And Mitch, I mean, I've seen people show up over there, and Mitch will take the time and say hello to him. I say he does it every time, but he's still personable to do that. And I think that's rad in an industry where it's still growing and growing and growing, but you can still like shake that guy's hand that used to be, you know, in other industries, you can't always do that.
Right, right. Well, from the second I kickstarted this bike, it was like, wow, it took me back to when I was racing Supercross, racing 125s, listening to some of the, you know, the Pro Circuit bikes back then. Kevin Windham's bike, these types of things. It was amazing. This bike is jetted so clean. It's so crisp. I mean, there's not a hesitation. There's not a hiccup. It's just brap, brap. I mean, I got so excited when I started the bike. And then taking it out onto the start straight here, going through the gears the first time, there is no holes in this power at all. The thing just absolutely screams. So cool. What did you think? Just going through the gears down the straightaway.
Amazing. Yep. You know, I'm obviously out of shape, but just going up towards that Talladega turn, and I'm trying to shift it, and my arms are pumping up, and I can't pull the clutch in all the way, and it won't shift, and I'm screaming this thing out. But you know, it just that power. And as long as I was on the pipe, it didn't matter the chop or the bumps, because it was just gonna stay in track. No problem. The suspension was just on point. The motor was pulling, no problem. And you know, I'm a 220 guy.
Yep.
And I was having a blast. It's the smile factor.
So the pipe, the porting, the engine, it's all crisp. It hits hard, but it's still a 125. You were talking about the gearing a little bit earlier. You mentioned it. We went from a 49 stock to a 51.
51.
Went
yeah,
up
went
a couple
up to 51.
Teeth. Pretty important to do for Todd. 220, I'm 200. Best 125 on earth is going to want to fall on its face. Gearing helps a lot, absolutely. But man, that thing pulled so well. And in fact, a couple times I didn't nail a corner perfect, and I had to hit the clutch a couple times. And I go, hey, you know what? I'm going to go back and do that again. And I thought maybe I was in second. I needed to downshift to first. I was in third, and the thing almost carried third. It adds that much power, and that's highly unlikely for a 125.
I was watching you go up the big Talladega turn there, and I watched you just haul the mail into it. But as you were exiting out of it, that thing, the front end still wanted to come up on you. It wasn't like you were in like this crazy low gear that would just lift it up. You were still hauling the mail through the turn, and it just wanted to come up on you. But it was easy for you. It seemed like you were under control, no craziness, and then you hit that second jump. It was like, boom, no problem.
You know, magazine work, you're going for the shot, right? So you go in slow and then pop the clutch and stuff. But no, we're going like 35 or 40 through that turn, and the front end is still wheeling, and it kind of caught me off guard. I'm like, wow, this thing is pulling hard. So speaking of that, I hate to say it, but I could have gone faster. But I'm going in, and I'm almost wide open going in, and I chop for just a second, and then I get back on it, and it's like, man, I didn't need to chop. Part of the reason is this suspension is so good and so planted. You know, you forget how light 125s feel. And when I have ridden them in the past, they do feel light and skittery, like they want to skate on top of the track. This bike felt planted, and very, very secure and tight to the track surface, much like a four-stroke, right? When you have that engine braking as you go into turn and it kind of plants the bike and it makes it feel heavy. This never felt heavy. It felt light, but it felt planted and very confidence-inspiring. And I was just expecting it to be a little bit skatey, so I kept chopping. I didn't need to chop. If I spent a little bit more time on this bike, I could be a lot more aggressive on it because it's very confidence-inspiring.
I think the bike is, the one thing I have with the bike, just from the small time that I rode it, is I got the confidence factor. It's the same as like when we rode the Roczen bike. And one thing I like to explain to people when we talk about like this bike or that bike is when you look at this bike, it's the package. You're paying for the package. You're not paying for, hey, I want X triple clamps and I want these linkage rods and I want this, this, and this. What you're doing is you're getting on this bike, you got, it's a show A kit, sure, but it's the Pro Circuit valving, it's their setup, it's their linkage, it's their settings all the way through. And it's not, you know, it's not a bunch of companies trying to come together to make something. This is a cohesive setup right here.
You bet.
And so you have the motor that's all tied in, and you got the suspension that's all tied in, and just the way you fit in that cockpit on the Yamaha. And I've never owned a Yamaha 125, and I'm in love.
Yep.
So it was just a great bike to ride. I wish I was more in shape to really enjoy it, which this is going to be a little bit more motivation to, you know, hey, drop some more weight and get on it and ride it. But, you know, I think we were talking about it when you came off, and we were looking at the band around the front fork.
Yeah.
I mean, the suspension is set up so perfect. We were about an inch and a half from the from bottoming.
Yep.
It just seems like it's in that perfect zone right now. And I think, obviously, the guys down there, they hit that one perfectly for us.
They did. And the bike, like I said, it just felt balanced. It handled very well. You forget how good a 125 corners. You're gonna have a ton of fun on this thing. Cause look, I'm 46, you're a little over 50. At this point, it's all about just having fun on a bike, right? I'm not racing that much. I don't care that much, but this was a really fun day. I would love to have something like this. It's just a whole nother layer of fun. Not every day, right? Sometimes you wanna ride the 450, sometimes you might wanna ride a 250. But having a 125 Yamaha to break out that works this good, amazing.
No, I was telling my social media guy, I go, I think we might have to pack this up and head to that Swap Moto Race Series race at Monster Mountain, because they got the 125 Unlimited there. So maybe we got to head out there and try that out in September. But I think that'll be fun to do, or just take it out to a couple of vet races and just have fun with it. It's a bike that you can get hurt on, I think, very fast, because if you don't respect it, because it's a 125, I'll just fling it this way and that way, no big deal. But no, I think it's got the power, but it's that Pro Circuit build, and I feel like in my mind it's like Pro Circuit confidence.
Yep. So. Yep. Yeah, Todd, I really appreciate it. Super fun day. Thank you very much for the opportunity.
Thank you.
You're gonna call me again in about a year. What else are you coming up with? I'm looking forward to it.
Let's talk to my wife. Let's see what we need to do next.
Let's thank your wife. I appreciate your wife. But guys, thank you very much for tuning in. Thank you for Todd coming out, letting us ride his bike. Custom Upfits, check him out. And thank you to our friends at Lee At. Guys, have a good day.